last week, a man walked into a mosque and killed 49 Muslims during prayer. Also last week, 69 Nigerian Christians were killed by Islamic militants, while a Jewish man was murdered in a Palestinian terror attack. Now, all those who heard about those last two, say aye. The world lost its mind Friday morning after news broke that a gunman had walked into two New Zealand mosques and opened fire, killing 49 people and wounding countless others. But the shots were still echoing off the walls when the left started wielding this story as a political cudgel against Donald Trump, his voters, conservatives, strong immigration supporters, gun owners, and the ever-mysterious white supremacist. The attack spurred global calls for solidarity with Muslims, while CNN blamed Trump, and Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez went all out against white racists and Islamophobia. But here's something you probably haven't heard. In Nigeria, more than 120 Christians have been killed and over 140 homes have been burned by militant Fulani Muslims since February, 69 of them in just the last week. The victims included men, women, and children. One woman, who suffered severe injuries after an attack, later delivered a stillborn baby. Now raise your hand if you heard any of this on CNN. Probably not. Even though some global agencies are now calling violence against Nigerian Christians an all-out religious genocide, thousands were killed last year alone. In the Congo, Muslims with the Allied Democratic Forces killed 6 people, including 3 women and a 9-year-old boy, Sunday, in an attack that forced another 500 people to flee their predominantly Christian village. In the majority Hindu nation of India, hate crimes against Christians jumped 57% in the first 2 months of this year. 2 men were murdered in February for their faith. In another incident, a female pastor was assaulted into unconsciousness by a police officer during a raid on a church. When the cops thought she was faking, they poured boiling tea in her mouth. And here was the scene in the Gaza Strip this weekend, where Palestinians celebrated a terror attack that killed one Jewish man and wounded another by passing out candy in the streets. Happened about 48 hours after the mosque shooting, but I didn't see this clip on AOC's Twitter feed. Interesting that a crazy man shooting up a mosque immediately launches global cries of sympathy for the Muslim community, while the genocide of thousands of Christians in Africa gets crickets. And pay no attention to Palestine celebrating the death of Jews. It's almost as though the media cherry-picks what evil it's going to focus on in order to spin a particular narrative, while all that inconvenient stuff just gets swept under the rug. But see, here's the funny thing about evil. It doesn't have any common denominator, except that it's evil. It doesn't know any particular race, skin tone, ethnicity, or political persuasion. It certainly doesn't hold allegiance to any president. Oh, but the left wants you to think it does. Now, you can grasp at one event in another country and use it to paint millions of Trump supporters as violent racists all you want, but all that does is make you part of the problem. And it shows you're willing to turn a blind eye to the evil in the rest of the world if it doesn't fit your political narrative and make for a handy weapon to wield against people you don't like. So yeah, the guy who walked into that mosque in New Zealand and opened fire is about as evil as they come. And those militant Muslims who just massacred a whole bunch of Christians in Nigeria that you didn't hear about, they're no better, even if the left won't talk about them. And that's your Reality Check America. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube page, like us on Facebook and Twitter, and stay informed.